Let me thank all of you for holding on so long all day. This is really amazing. The room was full at 9 a.m. and it's still pretty full now. It's amazing in this horrible weather. I really loved the day because I think it did. I know this was the panel that was called The Future, but I think in a sense, all of it was about the future. I think that talking about theory, as Robert Digraph's panel did, about the beauty, about these ideas that we find and we follow and that resonate and give us new ways of looking at the world and how they, you know, pay off in unanticipated ways, as, you know, the gems of our thinking will always do. And then the second panel on machine learning, which, you know, now there's so much hype around machine learning, but there is also so much promise and so many questions. And I think for us, you know, there are so many applications of machine learning that we have yet to see, you know, in the healthcare domain and in so many other domains. But I think, again, we're going to find that strand of beauty. We don't yet understand why it works. And I think that will bring those of us who love theory and those of us who care deeply about the social good that can come out of machine learning together. We are really just at the very beginning of machine learning. Then I guess we had the panel on platforms, which I found amazing, from, you know, scholars who really study platforms with their two new books, which were amazing, to, you know, someone who's the chief economist for one of the biggest platforms in the world and one that is most functional due to the fact that it came with its own set of social norms, you know, which was really a blessing for LinkedIn, right? The other ones, what were the norms? Who knows? And with Bridget on it, who, how many millions of followers does she have? 4.6 million followers. I mean, just amazing. So just, and I love the fact that she's back in grad school. As she creates this following, she's studying this following. And that was, to me, that was just amazing. And then the fate panel, Hannah's fate panel, fairness, accountability, transparency, and ethics, which I think is one of the most important developments in, you know, of the past decade, that we want to find ways to, rather than having AI compound the injustices, make things less interpretable, rather than doing that, having AI help us ultimately to make decisions that are fairer than human judgments, but we must define what we mean by fairness, which is why we must work with legal scholars and ethicists and philosophers. And then finally, this panel, which, as you can see, I stacked with people who don't make wild predictions of the future, but who ground us and provide motivations for that path, we should be looking towards, you know, taking all these other things into it. I mean, I love this lab. I love MSR in general, and really, you know, I am deeply indebted to Microsoft for supporting us in doing this kind of research. I guess we're pretty smart. So we figure out ways to make this pay off for the company because we live in a world of incentives.
But, you know, it's just an additional constraint. We want to do great things, create great social good, and also, make this a good proposition so that other companies will do this. You know, as I say, the just another constraint, and the unconstrained life is not worth living. So thank you, everyone.
I need to thank you. You get, sit down there, because you are one of them. Nicole Immorlica and her committee put together this amazing program. One thing that's happened to me is I get more and more labs to manage, more and more jobs that I have to let go. And I only want to let go to people who are amazing. And I let go the planning of this to Nicole, who did an amazing job, and to Lauren, who's back there, who doesn't like to be called out, but there she is, who just did a spectacular job. And I only trust brilliant perfectionists, and both of you are brilliant perfectionists.
Okay.
Thanks so much, Jennifer. It was a great pleasure to share this wonderful day with all of you, and I'm quite pleased. Maybe we could give a round of applause to all of our panelists that I think we chose very well right now. There is now a reception from 5 to 7 with a live band. There's going to be a little surprise around 5:30, I think, so stick around. It'll be great.